I wanted to sing a song about change, but I stopped myself because I'm a bad singer, guys. I want to be like, it's time for change. Jesus Christ. Okay, let me stop fooling around. Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. On the previous video, I talked about self-introspection, right? I asked you a question and as expected, I believe that you have answered it. And so if you did, you are ready for this video, all right? Because this is like more like a second step, right? So if you haven't watched the previous one and you're watching this one, I'll say pause, go back to that one, listen to the question, answer it, and then come back to this one, because it really requires you to be in that state of mind where you're ready to face whichever demon that's been, you know, on your back all this time and preventing you from achieving what you want. Right, so without wasting any more time, let's get into today's video. So yes, let's start with an intro. Let's get started. Welcome back. Alright, oh my god, I feel so tired, but it's still in the morning. I don't know how that can be, but yes. So today's video, right, self-introspection was our previous video. This video will be focusing on success list versus the to-do list, because if you want to achieve something really, you have to know the difference between these two things. But most of the time people fall into the to-do list. Why? Because they feel like writing a lot of things makes them feel like they are, I don't know, but that's what happens. All right, so the success list. A success list consists of like a few things. It also is completed most of the time. Like most of the time people complete that success list instead of their to-do list. That's why Tony Robbins was saying that people always say they should. I should do this, I should do that, and I should do this. But then they don't really do those things that they say they would. That's because it's a should instead of a must. So a success list is a must do thing, and a to-do list is a should do thing. That's why nothing or maybe two things are completed out of 10. Okay, so today I urge you to take this path, which is a success list. From here on, after watching this video, start doing your success list instead of a to-do list. Now I will tell you how to do a success list. For you to be able to make a success list, God, for you to be able to do your success list, you need to first find out what is your priority, okay? What is the most important thing that you have to do? What is that thing that you say, okay, I want to do this, and then do this, and do that. And most of the time, you have to have like at least four things that you're supposed to complete in a day. I said it, four things, because if you spend more time on something, it's gonna like the how should I put this? If you spend more time on doing a certain something, that means it's gonna turn out well. Let's say you take a lot of time studying a certain subject, you will pass it. Okay. So the second thing is that know that when you do that success list, it must be a must for you. Do it regardless. You don't feel like it, do it. All right. That is why it's called a must and not a should. So if you're not prepared to do that thing that you say you're gonna do, then I say just stick to your to-do list. The other thing is, a success list will help you to build habits. New habits, or because a habit is bred by consistency. You do those things again and again and again for a certain period of time. At one point in time, those things will just come so easy to you that you just do them every single time, okay, without having a problem. So let me give you an example. I personally used to do a to-do list. I don't know if I should, but it was a to-do list though, because I had so many things that I had to complete in a day that sometimes I felt so drained. And those are the one of the disadvantages of having a to-do list instead of a success list, because it has so many things, right? I had like, oh my god, I was supposed to write, to edit, to study like about 3 subjects in a day. I had to practice, you know, my communication skills. Oh my god, I had so many things that I was supposed to do. But then now I realized that for me to be able to complete and go somewhere, you know, I have to stick to just 4 things, you know, just 4 things in a day. So I said, okay, fine. What is my priority? To me, the biggest priority of all is my schoolwork. I have to do my schoolwork. So I say my schoolwork is my priority, which is the first thing that I do in the morning, studying, right? And then the second thing, what is it? I want to grow. Self-development, I also go through that. What do? I read books, right? Self-help books. And then, what else? I write, right? So I said consistency builds habits. So I said, okay, fine. I'm going to start writing from 6 until 8 so that at the end of the day, writing to me becomes as easy as breathing. You know, that's how a habit is. At one point, it becomes as easy as breathing. So I wanted to do that. And then what else? I said 4. Writing, studying. I forgot the other one. I remember, but I forgot it. But that's how it is. So those are like, to me, the most important things that I really want to work on at this time. Okay, so I urge you to do that. That's why I gave you such an example that I have like 4 things that I do, and so that I can be able to finish my book as early as possible and start editing it. Yeah, so that is how it is. So I don't want to indulge more into this, but then if you like this video, tell me in the comments if you are ready to start the success list instead of the to-do list. So I want to leave you with this, a question really, because I want you to really think about it. What is the most important thing that requires more of your attention? What is the most important thing that requires more of your attention? Right? Priority, remember? And then now, as I end this video, I want to tell you that you have to know that having so many things to do doesn't show that you are progressing. It shows that you are not gonna complete a lot of things early. So what I'm saying is focus on things that matter, and everything else is gonna be easy. So yes, that was it for today. I hope it helped, because this is the next step, right, after self-introspection. So if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Again, press the subscribe button to support and to see my other videos. And yes, without taking any more of your time, thank you for watching. I'll see you next time.